at AM 1050 KCAA.
Coming up next, Sin Censura, The Three Guys Rant.
You ready for the pain? You feel completely dirty when you're done. Irvin, are you ready for blast off?
I told you not to eat Indian food, man.
How are you blasted off? Prematurely.
We are
The Three Guys Rant.
Arvin, Mike, and Phil.
I already feel dirty.
Call us at 855-693-GUYS.
And if you didn't understand that, let me tell you to English, because that was Puerto Rico. You are listening to The Three Guys Rant. 855-693-GUYS. That's 693-4896.
693?
I love me some pizza.
All right. Good morning, my borrachos. We're back here with The Three Guys Rant.
Wait, bro. Save that for this. He says it's September, man. Okay, can we get into it, please?
So we're here with Arvin El Valiente, Phil El Mundo, and Mikey El Borracho is just walking in. I don't know why his hand is on his crotch, but I'm glad we all made it here. Again, if you want to reach out and touch one of us, 855-693-GUYS, 855-693-GUYS.
Did you say that somebody wants to touch us?
Yeah, why not?
All right.
Everybody wants to touch me.
Hey, I'm upset, by the way. Where's my stalker from down under? Was it Mandy? Hey,
you got to be more specific.
Mandy? Mindy? What was her name?
Oh, you know what? I do have a message. Next segment, we'll get into it. Mikey, you want to say hi?
Hi.
So, again, I just want to say, you know what?
I was feeling unloved.
It's been an exciting week. Football's on the way. My Chargers played. I still haven't had a chance to sit down and watch the game, so I don't know. So if anybody knows, don't call in and ruin it for me. I'm planning on watching the game at some point this week. Boardwalk Empire started, but more importantly, Sons of Anarchy started last night. And boy, is it going to be a good season.
Don't say anything.
You didn't see it?
There's a lot of people that haven't seen it yet.
Well, you know what, people? Then you should change the channel now, because we're going to talk about it.
Change it. What are you?
Change the channel.
You selling chia pets now? What is it with you?
Chia.
Yeah, I guess so.
You know what? I hate me any kind of bush, Phil, so I'm against the chia pet. Wait, that was something else. So it's you know, talking about football, I want to talk about something that every team. You want to just sit on my lap? Every team should start doing this. The Atlanta Falcons are doing the Memories program. Now, had you heard about this? I bet you Mike hasn't heard about this.
The Memories program?
Memories program. So for all, I repeat, all season ticket holders, if you're one of those, the cheerleaders will come up to your seat and take pictures with you.
Wait, but with what team?
Atlanta Falcons. That's what I said. Atlanta Falcons. But,
so you got to say season ticket holders of a sorry excuse for a team.
Phil, you are a Cowboys fan, so I'm surprised they didn't start this in Dallas.
Did you not see the sold-out crowd on Sunday?
You know what I saw? I saw the other team scoring the first 11 seconds. A little bit.
All right, there you go. Yeah, to go watch a losing game.
Hey, well, you know what? You guys say whatever you want, okay? You say whatever you want.
I don't know why they keep Romo around, man.
And the part that was the best part of the whole game, aside from the fact that I agree Romo sucks, should be shot, taken out back to the woodshed.
Right.
I'm with you. No problem there. But I knew the two of you would have a heart attack. Did you see what the game was titled?
America's
Game of the Week, baby. Why? Because America's team was playing.
Mikey, did you see the game?
Yes.
The whole thing?
Yes.
It was painful. I got to tell you, man.
I was feeling the pain for my brother.
As a Cowboy fan, it was painful. And then what's funny is I get a lot of flack because I want, you know, a website that says, you know, Romo must go. I'd like him fired. I want him gone. I think Romo sucks. I think he sucked from the day he started. I've never been a fan.
Whoa. On paper, he is a dominating quarterback.
Bro, if you throw three-yard passes and you complete 99 out of 100, that's great. But when you can't win a game and are colorblind and keep throwing to the other team...
Yeah, I don't know what the hell. It's almost like somebody from the other team paid him to just throw them the ball. It was bad.
I didn't understand the whole thing. Now, I said this a long time ago. For those of you that are Cowboy fans, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
You are like one of two people that I know that's still a Cowboys fan.
No way, brother. It's the community is enormous. And what's funny is for those
outside of Dallas,
I'm telling you, dude, you don't even know the numbers. It's staggering. Okay. It makes any team you like and any team Mike likes combined times five.
Really? Because I like Manchester United. So I don't know.
I'm telling you what. I'll bet you that Manchester United, in terms of fans, worldwide, okay, the Cowboys are up there.
I'm talking about dollar-wise.
Ah, see, here you go again.
See, you didn't like that answer, did you?
What are you talking about, though? We're only behind them by about $100 million.
Oh, is that it? Let me get that out of my pocket.
And what's no, you know what, Hooker? Manchester United is now worth less than the Cowboys.
That's impossible.
Real Madrid is... Would you please tell him who doesn't read the news?
Real Madrid.
Look, I listen to Madrid every morning.
He's an idiot.
He has nothing to do with
He's
soccer.
An idiot. Real Madrid is number one. The Cowboys are number two in the world.
I thought you were talking about the radio personality. Different Madrid?
You're up okay. there. Anyway.
It's the coolest story I've ever heard in my entire life. That's insane. Can I hear it again? Do you have time?
So the NFL is back. I agree. The Cowboy game was painful and atrocious.
So was the Packers game.
Yeah, that was bad. Yeah. That was bad. But who was the, was it the Falcons who had the exciting overtime game?
Huh. Somehow we come full circle back to the Atlanta Falcons.
Yeah, I think it was the Falcons program. But what, I think it was the Falcons. That was an exciting
that was a very good
fourth
game,
quarter,
yes.
Went into
yeah.
overtime.
Yeah, and they ended up winning at the
end. It was, that was awesome.
Yeah, that was a good game.
Excellent, excellent game. So to Arvin's point, I'm sorry, I had to sandbag him there, but Atlanta Falcon season ticket holders
are smart.
Can take pictures with the cheerleaders.
Their attendance is going to go up.
And the Ravens season ticket holders can take pictures with Ray Rice. He's got a lot of free time.
Ouch! All right, before we get into all of that madness, I did want to say, Arvin, have we heard any, has anybody gotten back to us? Because we did the Ice Bucket Challenge. A little late, I admit.
Oh, let's talk about that.
Okay, so I just wanted to say, I'm not trying to toot our own horn. Holy Jesus, was the water colder than I ever thought it was going
to
be.
Phil, you don't need to toot your own horn. That's what I'm here for.
But I'm just saying, we did call out three other people, and I'm just curious if there's been any feedback.
There's been congratulations from one of them. I'm not going to say no names, Aaron Sanchez.
Is he accepting the challenge?
He stepped over the challenge, so I don't know if...
Aaron, come on, man!
So I know that we were called... You know, I really thought we were going to skate by on this one, because I don't know if it's losing momentum, but I'm like, you know what? Enough time is going to go by. We kind of went under the radar. Nobody's going to say it. Within 24 hours, we got numerous requests. So first off, Chef Bev from Hell's Kitchen, F you for being the first one to call us out. And then also over at GCN, which you've been very kind to us, they called us out and said, you know, if we want to do something as a station. So we did. So we called out somebody over there. We called out Aaron and Kelly of the Aaron and Kelly Show. And more importantly, Paul Lane. I've been trying to get a reaction from him, but he's not even taking my call right now. Like, he almost knows it's coming.
I don't blame him. So people have been Facebooking me about how hard my nipples looked. And people wanted pictures of that. I don't know why, but, you know.
We can make that happen before the end of the show.
I'll tell you what, I could have cut glass with my nipples right after it pulled that water on me, man.
Wow, so we went from Atlanta altitude cheerleaders to his nipples.
This is a good segue.
It's a what?
It's a good segue.
I got nothing, Phil. So, again, everybody wants to make sure to check out the video. Go to our Facebook page, The Three Guys Rant, and you'll go ahead and see it on there about halfway down the page. And it was a good about minute and a half
video. I just got one piece of advice for anybody who's going to do the Ice Bucket Challenge. Make sure your bucket is clean, because apparently the bucket they gave me, they had to use to mix some sort of plaster, and it wasn't washed properly. So by the end of the challenge, I looked like it had snowed on me.
Mikey, I don't want to say nothing, but that might have been bodily fluid.
It did taste kind of salty.
All right, you're just filthy on so many levels.
It wasn't supposed to be brown?
You know what? We're gonna
I think it's going to go on to the next one.
Well, you know, we only got about a minute left, but we've got so much exciting NFL news to talk about. Gentlemen, I think I've discovered the deity that does exist.
It's not
Dallas. Can you let Arvin Google deity so he knows what the hell we're talking about?
Diddity.
As far as Arvin heard giggity, giggity, giggity.
It's D-I-D-D-Y.
This is the Three Guys Rant. We'll be right back after the break. Stick around.
Are you watching the game at home? Why? Come watch it at Mambo Grill, the hottest spot in Downey. You'll have good food, drinks, and a great time at a low price. We have the coldest beer in our sports bar, where you can enjoy the game on any of our huge flat screen TVs. And when your home team wins, you get 25% off anything in Mambo Grill. We're on Downey Avenue, one block north of Firestone, or visit us on the web. Mambo Grill, love at first bite.
Do we have your attention? When it comes to tequila, two things matter: heart and passion. Never compromising integrity for mass production. Number One Tequila delivers the goods. Taste the heart and passion of Mexico in every bottle. We make it right. We make it fun. Superior Tequila. There's only Number One. There's only Number One. There's only Number One.
Looking for some swag? Make sure to check out monsterclothing.com. They got everything from V-necks, t-shirts, hoodies, baby dolls. And remember, custom orders are always welcome and much more.
They're just not on the site yet.
www.monsterclothingco.com or call them at 888-49-MONSTER. 888-49-MONSTER.
Hablamos español.
Do-do-do!
Nurses Life Express provides unique apparel for all the hardworking nurses that wear many hats. It's apparel that expresses nurses' amazing, humorous, and caring personalities. After all, nurses are as influential as their united goal to help others. Nursing's not easy, but somebody's got to do it. For more information, please call 562-270-4312 or visit their website at www.nurselife.com. www.nurselyfe.com. NursesLife.com, where nurses' lives are expressed.
KCAA Radio, Loma Linda, where no listener is ever left behind.
This is Becca Bateau. When I'm not reading 50 Shades of Grey and driving men crazy, I spend my time dreaming about the three guys Rant, Arvin, Mike, and Phil. Yeah, right.
Streaming live from Los Angeles and worldwide, The Three Guys Rant with Arvin, Mike, and Phil. Check out our website at www.thethreeguysrant.com. The Three Guys Rant starts now.
Already recording.
Are you ready?
Yep. Go.
This is a Three Guys Rant, part of the GCN family, and we're going to call out our three people for the Ice Bucket Challenge. Number one,
Catherine Albrecht.
Number two, Paul Lane.
Number three and four, Aaron and Kelly from the Live with Aaron and Kelly show.
So here we go.
One, two, three.
Ah! Yes!
Wow.
Phil?
That was a good times. Good times.
It was colder than I expected.
You know what? That was a trigger that made me think. You asked about Melanie earlier. That was her question or response or whatever it was, because apparently that video went semi-viral. She asked.
Really? So six people saw it, or did we hit double digits and 10 people saw it?
Five people saw it.
I was gonna say. Okay.
She was asking, did Mikey really just scream like a girl in that video?
the only viral thing is what we're gonna catch from that water. Because I was feeling a little bit under the weather after that, man.
What part of Hollywood did you go to after that challenge?
I don't know, man.
Anyway, I was talking about Cowboy fans and when the Clippers owner got in trouble for all his racist rants.
Right.
A lot of the Cowboy fans received I don't know if it was a tweet or a text or whatever, and it said, please God, let Jerry Jones say something racist.
Right.
Okay. Because, you know, we're hoping he could sell the team. Well, half of it has come true. Apparently, back in 2009, a whopping 5 years ago, Jerry Jones did something to a former exotic dancer.
Good. I'm glad to hear it. He should have done something to her.
And she's now come out, and she's asking for monetary relief of over $1 million.
That's pocket change for
her. Is that what I sound like when I do my stories?
Yeah. Because we don't know what the hell the story's about, but
and I don't know what the hell
Jerry
he's talking
Jones
about.
Did something to somebody.
That's all it says. Jerry Jones, and she's filed a A former exotic dancer has filed a lawsuit against the Dallas Cowboy owner Jerry Jones, accusing him of sexual assault.
What makes her exotic?
Who cares? As a Cowboys fan, all I want this to do is snowball enough in the media. Dory's got to sell the team.
That'll never happen.
Somebody should
not for something like that.
Come on. I haven't asked for anything for Christmas.
You need to start photoshopping a picture of him and Donald Sterling in the same picture. Then maybe it'll grow some.
I don't think Cowboy fans will care.
But what about Goodell? Goodell, do you think he's going to keep his job?
I don't know, man. The public's finicky. The media's finicky. It's hard to say. They're coming down hard.
You know what I didn't know is how much the NFL pays that guy.
It's $9 million a year, right?
$40 million a year.
$40 million a year?
Google it.
That seems extremely high. Feel googly-oogly.
Is it $40 million a year?
Yep.
He's making more than most players. He's making more than almost every player.
They're saying under him, revenues for the NFL and profits have been astronomical.
Okay, I don't know if it's necessarily him, really like him or if it's Facebook and Twitter that are helping with that.
For what? The revenue?
Well, if you start building excitement, it all starts with social media.
Yeah, but you know who's going to always take credit, man? It's the CEO, the guy at the top.
Is there anything that he's done that can stand out as opposed to something that wasn't done before?
Yes, give Ray Rice a 2-game suspension for knocking out his girlfriend. That stood out real quick on people.
Do you think he's going to come back?
Yeah.
I think he will too. I think if they let Mike Vick come back, I think they'll let him come back.
Yeah, but now you're comparing women with dogs.
I know. I'd rather have the dog.
Arvin at the3guysrant.com.
Boy, you guys turn quick.
No, but he's going to come back. And then even on the press conference today, the commissioner said that he could see him coming back to play. If he deals with his family issues, his anger, he could see him coming back.
Did he make it seem like he's going to come back this season?
No, it's not going to come back this season.
Now, I know over the last 24 hours, the wife has come out and basically said, you know, leave us alone kind of stuff. He didn't do nothing, blah, 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 this, that, and the other. Do you think she's trying to write it out so that she can keep her paycheck?
Of course. What woman wouldn't do that? I don't think if there was a video, she would have never said anything about it.
No, but that's what I'm saying. Do you think she's trying to support him so that he can go back and play?
Of course.
So she can still continue shopping.
Of course, absolutely.
Phil?
Absolutely. I mean, the guy's been in the league 7 years, all right? He had some good sponsorships. Some good endorsements. So hopefully he was wise with his money. He has some good financial advisors, and he can hopefully he doesn't even have to work anymore. So who cares?
You know what? I think it's time to go down the yellow brick road because apparently we have a floating head here on the screen.
Gazoo?
Straight out of China, baby.
He looks Chinese too. Look at him.
Hello, boys.
Straight out of China. Now, somebody who makes more than Goodell, because Goodell, apparently, Mikey, you are right. Goodell made $44.2 million last year. But John Kudis, our little buddy from down under, is currently in China. He makes that in a week.
Yep. Whoa, what the hell? Why the hell did I pick up the tab when we went to McDonald's while he was here then?
Maybe it's in yen or pesos, but he makes more than $44.2 million. How you doing, bud?
I'm very good, boys. How are you boys doing?
Good. So what are your thoughts? Ray Rice, Goodell, the NFL, what do you think?
You know, we also have a couple of different football leagues here in Australia. And one of the most prominent, well, there's two very big prominent ones here, called AFL, which is Australian Football League, and NRL, which is the National Rugby League. Two different codes, but two very high-profile sports around the country, and they are played in other countries as well. Now, the CEO of the AFL was Alex Dimitriadis. He was a Greek guy, and he was paid something like, I think, $4 or $5 million, and that's per year. But he was also on a bonus when the code did well. He also got rewarded for that. Now, I'm going to ask you a question for this guy running the NFL. Does he get a bonus on top of that, or is that his flat salary?
No, that was salary, bonuses, and benefits.
That's everything, is it?
Yes.
Not a bad chunk of change.
Because I tell you what, not a bad chunk of change. I think the bonus I would give him is a punch in the balls.
That's true. yeah.
You know, like, that's just ludicrous. I mean, how much money does Obama earn every year?
$400,000.
But he only runs a country that makes no money and has to borrow from China. I mean, you know, if you're in the league.
That's a very good point.
If you're in the league that made $9 billion last year to split between 28 teams, come on, that's something to brag about.
Yeah, it is. It is. All right, let me ask you, what about CEOs of financial institutions like banks and mortgage lenders and things like that? Are they earning that amount of money?
Problem is, they don't bring you any joy, though. There's no happiness there. See, at least,
no, I didn't.
At least in the
it's
NFL.
It's not all about happiness. There's happiness for them earning that amount of money.
But it's not for the general public.
Man, that means.
So. The problem is America is addicted to football. America cannot wait for Sundays and Mondays and Thursdays during football season. And it's all about the money.
I know.
But I mean,
let me show you this quickly. Let me show you what China is addicted to. China is addicted to rice. It's breakfast time here. And they're all addicted to rice and eating.
Call the Three Guys Rant.
I'm hungry. We'll be right back.
Would you like to comment? Get on the radio.
Check out our website at www.thethreeguysrant.com.
The Three Guys Rant. Rant.
Three balls, two strikes, the pitch. Make your team look like pros with custom lineup cards. Whether you are a travel team, rec team, all-star team, or just some old guys playing slow pitch, we can make your team look a little better with some custom lineup cards. For the umpire, for the opponent, for the scorekeeper, for the dugout, no matter where your lineup card goes, you will look like a big league team with your team logo and name on top of your personalized lineup card. Just visit CustomLineupCards.com. With the best prices in town, you are sure to hit a home run with us. Visit CustomLineupCards.com and go pro.
Number one.
Is that a stutter or as high as you can count?
I was ordering number one tequila.
Everybody's asking for number one.
Great, another fancy bottle.
These guys are true artists. Never compromise integrity. They make tequila come on. Fashion. Never mass produce.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying have the number one. Anything less is number two.
Number one,
tequila.
ProTech Carpet and Tile Care provides professional cleaning services for carpet, tile, and grout, upholstery, and fine area rugs. We aren't just cleaning experts, we are restoration experts. We have saved our customers hundreds or even thousands of dollars on new flooring and upholstery expenses after we restored what they thought was permanent soil and damage. We are professionally trained and certified technicians. We specialize in damage restoration caused by heavy soil, odor, spot removal such as coffee, tea, ink, gum, wine, oil, paint, nail polish, and many more. If you want the best in home cleaning and professional services, call us today at 562-447-4300. We are ProTech.
Hey, everybody, it's Kiara Lynn Ford, and I'm listening to Rant Radio Network.
Streaming live from Los Angeles and worldwide, The Three Guys Rant with Arvin, Mike, and Phil. Check out our website at www.thethreeguysrant.com. The Three Guys Rant starts now.
All right, we're back from the break, and is our little buddy still with us, Alan, or did we lose him? We lost him. Okay, I guess he went back to eating Chinese food.
No, but you know what? I do have a question. I don't know if you've heard about this, but when you start making that kind of serious money, would you really care if you're coming up short by $2 million a year? Would you miss $2 billion. Would you miss it?
I don't understand.
Well, I don't know if you've heard, but CVS stopped selling cigarettes. Started doing some more research, and I didn't even know. I came across it by accident. I walked into one of the stores a few weeks back, and the shelves where the cigarettes were pretty much empty. I'm like, I asked one of the girls, I go, are you guys restocking, or what are you guys doing? Like, no, we're going to stop selling cigarettes, I think, at the end of the month. I'm like, yeah, right. They're not going to do that. Sure enough, it went official, I think, at the beginning of this month, and they're going to miss out on $2 billion a year across the company. I'm like, holy crap. I go, that's a lot of money, but in hindsight, they're actually making about $38 billion on everything else. So it's almost nothing to them.
That's right. It's nothing.
Now, why? What do you know what the whole reason was for
that? Yeah. Their whole philosophy is that if they are an institution that's
of
pushing
health,
they said that, you know, selling cigarettes wasn't with, you know.
So does that mean that they're going to go to patches and vape pens?
Yeah.
Are they really?
I think they're going to change their names too. They're going to add the word health to the logo. It's going to be CVS Health.
Probably, yeah. That makes more sense.
So they're trying, yeah.
So, I mean, save on. And again, I came across this picture, and I don't know if they were starting to give the last cigarettes away at for free or whatever, but that is a long line just to try to get into the store.
No, I think there's an actual Apple store on the other side, and people are really lining up, man.
And again, I don't know how many people are going to follow suit or whatever. I mean, I will say that more and more, I think a lot of people have gotten away from smoking cigarettes. But
I think so.
I don't necessarily know that it's a health choice. It's just damn expensive.
Yeah, it's expensive as hell, man.
I've heard a lot of people say, I got to quit. Is it killing you? Yeah, it's breaking me.
I was talking to a friend from New York, and he was talking, it's over $8 a pack.
Is it really up to $8 a pack?
He said, man, for $2 I could be smoking crack. You know, so, I mean, $8 a pack, that's rough, man. If you're a pack a day smoker, that's a lot of money, man.
I know people that go through about two and a half packs a day.
That's crazy.
How the hell do you have the time, though? That's the other thing I don't understand. And in today's world where you have nowhere you can smoke.
Well, right? It's funny that you say that because they'll light a cigarette, take 2-3 puffs, smoke maybe 20% of the cigarette, and throw it out. And they'll do that all day long.
Well, somebody that has too much money, because most of the smokers that I used to work with,
these people
were so broke, man. They were into the filter. They were just were sucking, dude. I mean,
woo. Whoa, was he one of them? No. And it's funny because you're absolutely right. These people that I
John's
know are this far away from being evicted and this far away from having their car repossessed because the habit is more important. What the hell is John doing, man? Look at that picture.
For those of you that are streaming, hearing the grunting noises, that's John Kunis back on from China.
Hello, boys.
So, John, you were saying, though, that you think the numbers are exorbitant, that these people make way too much money.
Yeah, I think what I'm saying is that if they're shown they're doing a good job and they're shown that they're making more money on what they're doing there and they're meeting their bonuses and whatever else, then obviously they're deserved of their money. But really, $40 million and for 1 year in sport? Didn't Arvin say that that's more than some of the players?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, it's much more. Absolutely. But again, this isn't just a sport. It's an institution now.
It is a tax-exempt institution at that.
Okay, I don't know what happened there. We lost something.
Yep, we lost them. Just let them.
John, hang on. We can't hear you. Hang on.
Talking.
Signal went away.
But
go ahead.
No. I was gonna go ahead and continue with your statement because I wanted to move on to the next thing.
That's fine. It's too much money.
You're absolutely right. It's too much money.
It'll make you happy.
But you know, staying on the whole where there's smoke, there's fire. Here in California, about 2 to 3 weeks ago, Colossus at Magic Mountain closed. Did you hear what happened? Less than beginning of this week.
You know, I knew that would pique your interest. I was like, I'm just going to leave that one alone because Arvin's going to be all hard up for this stupid story.
Do you think that they just use that as an excuse just to try to demolish the roller coaster quicker, saying that it was an accidental fire?
You understand they're not tearing it down.
Well, they're going to redo. It's going to be the Twisted Colossus now. So I'm assuming at some point part of that has to be made out of complete metal if it's going to have twists and loops and turns.
I realize you don't read.
I really don't.
Okay. They're going to overlay metal tracks.
Yeah.
Okay, that are
going to
be...
There's already metal tracks there.
Overlay metal tracks that'll help them accomplish what they're trying to do with the majority of the existing structure.
Yeah.
So they're going to be able to put it on a tube track, and then they're going to have the high-five one where two cars simultaneously are going to be going by. Did you watch the video at all? Did you look into any of the stories?
Just in case anybody's wondering what the hell we're talking about. We're talking about
Six Flags Magic Mountain.
Six Flags Magic Mountain.
In Valencia, California, shut down Colossus, which was 36 years old.
Right. The oldest
wooden roller coaster.
Right.
One of the old. And Arvin is all excited because it caught on fire a few days ago.
Right. I didn't say it was exciting. I'm just wondering if somebody's trying to reduce the cost of labor here.
By burning it down.
Absolutely.
Okay.
All right.
So we're going to do an insurance claim?
Whoa. I'm not trying to plant no ideas out there. So is the whole wooden structure then supposed to stay in place and what,
the vast majority of it is.
And the top of it's going to be all new metal, like the loopy coasters.
Well, on top of the current track form shape, they're going to lay new metal tracks. to allow these faster coasters.
Yeah, I got to see it to understand it.
Yes, I understand. All right. This is out for one of our psychotic listeners. I wanted to share this. And I'm glad Mikey's here because this is his favorite news of the world.
It's your favorite.
The Duchess of Cambridge is pregnant.
I heard about that.
Little baby George in the UK.
Who cares?
Is going to have a sibling.
Who cares?
More so.
Boy or girl.
They don't know yet. And Prince Charles is hoping it's a girl. He would like a granddaughter.
Shishi.
Shishi. So, John, are you back?
Yeah, I'm back.
We can hear you. We can't see you, but we can hear you.
John, Mike.
No, video. No video. We're going to try and keep it online and
all audio.
Offline.
All right, we're going to do all audio. So,
to be honest with you, I'd rather not see you, but anyway.
Mike gets mad every time the Royals put out a news release. And my wife, who's a fanatic, is so excited that Kate is pregnant.
I know your wife, and she's absolutely beautiful and gorgeous. But I'm going to agree with Arvin. She's fixated with the bloody Royals. What is wrong with her?
I know. What have the Royals done for her lately?
What have the Royals done for anyone lately?
I couldn't tell you.
It's just crazy, man.
Between the Royals and firemen, your wife and my wife are in all sorts of trouble.
John, I'm not seeing the downside here, John.
I reckon the girls might have been the one that set the fire out of that roller coaster so they can see all the firemen out there.
John, let me share a quick story with you. So one of our projects within our marketing company, we have a site, a blog called, and actually it's turning into a full site, firemenarehot.com.
Yes.
Arvin manages the site. Much to his dismay,
keep me and that's
Arvin is very, very bothered and troubled that 85% of our followers currently are men.
Oh no!
Okay,
I'd be bothered about that too.
And I'm like, whatever. This is 2014, and we're in California.
What was amazing is the amount of time that Arvin spends looking at firemen pictures.
Hey, yeah. Somebody's got to do the research.
And he claims that he's doing it for the good of the work.
Really?
Hey, John, you want to help him participate? I'm just saying. I could use a little sidekick.
Listen, man, I can do something that those firemen can't do. I can stand up my hose dreads on the ground.
Hey, John, we got about 30 seconds left in the segment. Give a shout-out, and then we're going to end up cutting you off.
All right, boys. Listen. I just want to say that you guys said that that roller coaster was, 37 years old?
Yes, sir.
Yep.
Is that right?
Yes.
Arvin, you're older than that, but we haven't shut you down.
Whoa, John. Whoa. First off, I am not older than that.
No, come on now.
Hey, John, have Holy a great crap, time wait, in I? China. We'll look forward to talking to you again next week.
Okay, boys. Talk to you soon.
Take All care.
Right. Bye-bye.
Hey, well, you know, something, since we're talking about Ray Rice.
We were?
Earlier, but I'll come back to it. I'll come back to it. It's a good twist. It's a good twist in the story.
This is the Three Guys Rant. We'll be right back.
No le van a cambiar de estación. El show de las tres comadres. Ahorita regresamos.
The Three Guys Rant.
What's wrong?
I can't stop craving a cigarette. I just quit. Hey, what are you smoking on?
Oh, this? Best e-juice on the planet. Burst of flavor, of course.
What's that?
Only the best alternative to smoking with a great flavor. It has a burst of flavor in every puff.
Well, does it have nicotine?
It comes in different levels, including zero. They have 20 flavors and more coming. All the products are made in the U.S. Check them out at www.burstoflavor.com or call them at 855-WE-BURST.
Hey, let's burst together.
It's not just flavor, it's an experience. Cigarettes, you've met your match.
Real Estate Rant and AGR Realtors are proud supporters of Michael Aguilar and Associates, advocates for stroke awareness and integrative healthcare.
In February 2012, I suffered a stroke due to high blood pressure. I was rushed to the hospital where I was admitted for the next 30 days. I was initially told I may have to stay in the hospital for about 3 months, but I made rapid improvements in my recuperation and continued to improve to this day.
When Michael left the hospital, he did not have insurance to cover his rehabilitation, so he focused on integrative healthcare to get better. At the end of 2013, seeing a need for stroke awareness, Michael started his own company, Michael Aguilar and Associates, to focus on creating awareness about the dangers of high blood pressure and stroke.
If you would like more information, please call me at 562-464-7297, or you can visit my website at www.strokeawareness101.com.
Michael Aguilar and Associates, creating awareness and saving lives one person at a time.
Experts know that for pastry, Baker's Bodega has it all. Exclusive brands like Westco Bankmark, Satin Ice, and Pastry Pride. One-on-one day seminars for cake decorating and gelatin art. So for our service, wide range of ingredients and supplies, and for the low prices, Baker's Bodega has it all. But you don't need to be an expert. Baker's Bodega, 7869 Paramount Boulevard in Pico Rivera. Come, we're waiting for you.
Buenos dias, buenas tardes, and a big old howdy, y'all. This is the Red Mexican Alex Raimundo with my amigos, the Three Guys Ranting, not to be confused with Three Guys Panting. That was me outside your window the other night, ladies.
Streaming live from Los Angeles and worldwide, the Three Guys Rant with Arvin, Mike, and Phil. Hot topics and headlines. Love doctors. Politics. The Three Guys Rant starts now.
All right, we're back from the break. Thanks for sticking around and listening to us. We have a whole bunch.
Wow. I'm not sure why the hell that one keeps playing. So please, Mikey, tell us about your twist.
Oh, no, never mind. It's over. Ray Rice, whatever. Go ahead.
How long have you been doing this?
Your twist is done?
No. It was just now there's also word that he may sue the NFL to come back to play because there's several players in the NFL that have been convicted of domestic violence, and there's still a lot to play. So he may have an argument as to how come I get a ban, but these guys
because not. There's a video of him doing it.
I understand that, but these guys were convicted. So they went to court, and they were convicted.
Okay, so that,
and they're still playing.
That probably meant that there was 40 people that know and but okay, judge and all
so
that.
So let's ask the underlying question, though. What are your thoughts on that as a whole?
About what?
Domestic violence in sports has been a huge issue forever and a day.
Yeah, I think this shouldn't be treated any different than anybody else. Had that been me and you caught doing that on video or over there, we would have been arrested.
So what I'm saying is, though, are you okay that all of these guys that are arrested for domestic abuse like that can be banned from the sport?
I don't know that they need to be banned forever. Maybe a stiff suspension, put them through a program like they would do, but a lengthy program. Maybe you get a year or 2 year suspension, and if you prove you're worthy of coming back, maybe you're given another shot. Something like that. I don't know. Something's got to be done. Something serious.
Arvin,
I don't know if lifetime is warranted. I
mean, yeah, I'm okay with it.
So am I.
Okay.
I'd like about. I mean, again, don't get me wrong though. That dirtbag Michael Vick. I wanted him taken out back and shot, too.
Yeah, and I agree with that, too.
Okay, so, I mean, the fact that they let him back in, that scumbag, I've never liked him. I mean, to me, I was disgusted by the whole thing. That bothered me. Thank God he wasn't on the Cowboys because that really would have caused me more turmoil. But the whole domestic abuse thing, I'm all for zero tolerance. I mean, we've said on this show there's no excuse for hitting a woman. Arvin says sometimes there is, but I'm going
to
say
I said sometimes they have to be taught a lesson. I didn't say knock them out with a pole in the elevator.
Arvin at thethreeguysrant.com. All I'm saying is I'm okay with it because I fear that, and I know we get backlash, and a lot of men always get backlash, but a lot of these women will sometimes stay, whether it's a meal ticket, a money ticket, a lifestyle ticket.
Right.
So this stuff, they need to put a stop to it as a whole.
That goes with anybody. It doesn't have to be an athlete. What if, okay, you're a private citizen and you get convicted of domestic violence? Do you have to, then should your employer fire you?
But it's completely different because they're in the public.
No, but we're talking about domestic
violence. And I'm okay with Mike, though. Mike's always one that he wants to take it to the next level. He doesn't because he doesn't like gray, so that's fine. Yes.
Really? Because there's a lot
of. If you beat up your wife, then, the drawback's going to be, though, where then if you get fired, now what? You go on government assistance? You qualify for welfare?
I don't know. That's what I'm asking.
That's your problem. You want you get mad when I say it's gray, but then you like, oh, I don't know.
No, I'm just saying. So is if you're going to do it like that for one subset of people, it's got to be for everybody. It's not, okay, if you're an athlete, if you beat your wife, we can bind you for life. If you're a private citizen and you lose your job, well, you can't go on welfare either, but nobody else wants to hire you. Okay, so where do we draw the line?
Simple. Swallow a bullet or take a 22 behind the ear. Don't beat your women.
Mikey for 2016, because that sounds just like a politician.
Speaking of Mikey for 2016... For all of you naysayers and people who like to gripe and talk smack and cry, do me a favor. At least listen to the president tonight.
Okay, it goes on at 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock West Coast time, 9 o'clock East Coast time. For those of you listening to us over on the Clam Chowder Power Hour.
Should be good.
Should be. Well, you know, he's going to talk about ISIS. Again, I mean, he's not the president I wanted after all. He's a little spineless as far as I'm concerned. I've been bothered by him. But we still owe him the time, and I think we should at least hear him out.
Do you think he'll address what tomorrow is?
Like during this speech, I don't think so. It's not about
you're,
that.
You're drawing a blank on what tomorrow is.
No, but I don't like when they address it because it gives the I don't want to use anything derogatory. It gives those individuals way too much credence.
But isn't what tonight's speech about going to be talked about?
No, because terrorism? ISIS is a whole different group of animals, man.
These guys are extreme terrorists.
Mikey, help me with the different names over there. You've got the other lunatics over there who even they're saying, look, man. We got nothing to do with these crazies. That's a whole subset of lunacy over there.
But you see, a lot of the leadership and the...
with Saddam's old army?
Yeah. His old generals and soldiers, you know, that's what happens when you go in and you just tear up a country. But who knows, man? We just got to nuke him. That's it. he should just come out and say, I've given the order to nuke him. And they should be in the back. We should see the freaking mushroom cloud. And that's it. Problem solved, America.
You know what? Last night there was a story. I don't know if you heard about it. There was a gentleman here in Southern California.
There's about a minute left. Oh no, that's the wrong time frame. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
There was a police pursuit of an older gentleman in a surplus truck. As soon as I heard about that, I'm like, damn it. That's Mikey. So I don't know if you heard about it, but he had the cops going on a slow pursuit chase.
I'm sorry, so the president's speech, and there's a slow pursuit chase.
You see, here
yesterday in
California, I wanted
right?
you to get there.
Seriously?
I wanted Seriously? You to get there.
What the hell is wrong with you?
Look, because all this violence coming out from you, I'm like, you know what? I go, that's going to be you in 20
years.
I'm
not opposed. I really wish there was a say to, look, everyone who wants out of country, go. Because in the next 72 hours, I agree with Mike, we drop the nukes, period. ISIS is there, not there. We make it a wasteland. They cannot go back.
But yes. wouldn't that mean that they'd end up being here?
No.
No, they're not going to.
But man, are we that area is becoming more and more destabilized. It's just something awful.
And you know what's amazing? We got rid of Saddam. We got rid of Gaddafi. And guys used to keep each other in check. That whole region seemed to be a lot better with those guys still there.
And they were killing less of their own people than these lunatics are.
Right. So, you know, who knows? So, but if you break it, you bought it.
Is that what you're trying to say?
No, I'm saying there's nothing we can do now, obviously. But, you know, we went in there because supposedly these guys were evil. We needed to get rid of them. And look what's going on now.
My favorite part about all of this, though, as sad as it is for those people over there, you know, I mean, I do feel for them. I know that we caused a lot of this. We'll leave out the previous president's name because some of our associates get all hot and bothered when we bring that up. You look at where the situation is now. And you look at Arvin's generation. He's 10 years our junior. They don't have a clue.
Sorry, what are we talking about? I drew a blank for a minute.
They understand none of it. They can't have an intelligent conversation. They can't have an argument. None of it.
Horse, run away. Horse.
So,
can I go back to my police pursuit now?
Okay, we're going to transition from world politics and the president speaking the night to Arvin. Please continue.
No, but you know what? The first thing I thought about, Mikey, can you buy military vehicles?
Some kind. Certain vehicles. Yeah.
Are you really asking that question?
Yeah. Did you see this truck? This is like a 2-lane truck that he was driving down the street with. And it was just because he failed to stop. You didn't see the video, did you?
I did see the video, but you understand that you can buy tanks. You can buy decommissioned surplus equipment.
You can buy that here?
You can buy a decommissioned post office vehicle.
I don't want a post office vehicle, but mine the tank. That'd be interesting.
It's not like you can take it out for a ride.
Well, that's what I'm asking, because this guy was driving it down the street. Well,
you can't.
Was it a tank?
No, it was a surplus truck.
You can take the tanks out to the desert areas and some of the.
Yeah, but it was. So it was just a truck.
It was a big truck.
Okay, so what?
I want to know how I can get. Okay, so what's the point? That I thought of you. That's what I thought about.
You think about me all the time. You think about me a little bit too much.
You know what? Moving on.
I don't like the texts at 2 or 3 in the morning.
Those texts aren't for me. Yeah. I don't know who the hell you're talking about. So for real, we can buy one of these trucks.
You know what I want to bring up real quick? Because, you know, I take my little boy to school every day. And I'm tired of seeing this. And I want to put it like a damn it. I'm drawing a blank.
You got 90 seconds left.
Okay. 9?
90.
Okay. I'm tired of seeing all these mothers, you know, and they're all Latina mothers, okay?
With what?
Walking
with husbands?
Walking their kids to school, all right? And they happen to be, you know, look like 9, 10 years old, maybe 12. Most of them bigger than their moms, and their moms are carrying their damn backpacks.
Oh, yeah, that bothers the hell out of me.
What the hell is wrong with these kids today, man? Holy Talk crap, I want to get out and just start smacking moms and kids. I don't care.
What, all right, get banned for life. We don't smack women. We don't smack women.
I'll make sure there's no video. But it's like, what the hell is wrong? I saw this kid today. I swear to God, he was as big as Arvin, going into an elementary school, and his mom carrying a backpack and like a lunch pail. And the kid is just doop, 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 doop.
But like, haven't we had this discussion? This is why kids are so soft. You got these helicopter mothers who are all over them, hovering constantly. They don't let them do anything.
Jesus. Women, let your kids grow up.
This is Three Guys Rant. Thank you for listening in. Make sure to check us out each and every week.
Transmitiendo en vivo en Los Angeles y alrededor del mundo. Would you like to comment? Get on the radio.
Check out our website at www.thethreeguysrant.com.
The Three Guys Rant.
If the truth hurts, then AM 1050 KCAA can be a real pain.
Looking for a delicious, fresh family meal that's ready when you are and easy on your budget? Welcome to Piara Pizza. We make our pizzas with handmade dough, 100% real cheese, and tomato sauce blended with our own spices. Nothing is ever frozen. We always have large pepperoni and cheese pizzas fresh and waiting for you for only $5. Or choose one of our specialty pizzas. We have veggie, meat lovers, supreme, and Hawaiian. Add an order of our amazing hot wings, cheesy bread, or breadsticks. Our locations are ultra-modern, ultra-clean, and open 7 days a week. Visit any one of our locations today. Or check us out on the web at www.piarapizza.com. Piara Pizza. Fresh, hot, and ready for you when you come in. Stop in for your Piara Pizza today.
Hey, what's going on? This is Frank Palangi here. You're listening to the Three Guys Rant Radio Show. Rock on.
Streaming live from Los Angeles and worldwide, the Three Guys Rant with Arvin, Mike, and Phil. Check out our website at www.thethreeguysrant.com. The Three Guys Rant starts now.
All right, welcome back to another rantisode of the Three Guys Rant on NBC News Radio, KCAA, 1050 AM. Now, Mikey, going off of what you said in the last segment, you know, kids in elementary school that are just moronic, why the parents still do everything the way that they do.
Right.
Now, you have two girls,
yeah,
but you raise them in a military home because you're a Marine. Okay. I don't know if you guys heard about this, but a Washington high school is requiring students and their parents to sign a contract that states students will not twerk, lap dance, or otherwise look like they're having sex on the dance floor during school-sanctioned events.
That's
why
boring,
in the hell wasn't this going on when I was in school?
Why are these schools so stupid? Why don't they have the parents sign a contract that says, I'm going to help my little idiot do his homework, learn to read,
mm-mm,
respect his teachers, become a more productive citizen? They're worried about twerking?
No.
There's a statistic, and I told Arvin about this. Arvin almost had a heart attack last week. A new statistic from, if I'm not mistaken, it's the NIH, the National Institute of Health.
Hold on. How do you spell that?
60% of teen boys who are watching porn where they thought it was going to become an epidemic are actually abstaining from sex because everyone's become so androgynous. These kids aren't even interested in sex anymore.
Androgynous. A-N.
What is wrong with these kids?
That's what I said.
You see, that's what I'm talking. It's because their moms keep babying them.
But okay, but they're worried about twerking and what's happening. Right. But they're rude. Fail. They're nasty. They're illiterate. They can't read or write. They can't form a complete sentence.
Is because raising a child actually takes work.
What kind of country they
want to dump them off at 8 and have to deal with.
But if you're going to sign a contract, really, that's the contract.
I would say.
What kind of country do we live in where you can't go to, you can't be a high school student and go to school and get a lap dance? What the hell is wrong with that?
That's what I'm saying, man. Right?
That's not the America I grew up in.
I remember being in school at these dances.
That's not the America
corner.
You went to another country and fought for,
man. I'm telling you. I remember my math teacher. She used to twerk. She was fine. And she used to get our attention that way.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Be like me.
So I don't understand what the problem is.
El calzón para el lado.
I'm telling you that the contract needs to be, if your kid gets less than a C average, we're taking your tax return.
There you go.
Simple.
Right. People would stop having kids.
Good.
I'm sorry, is that a caller? Online too?
Hello?
Yes?
Oh, it sounds like our stalker.
Long time listener. Not always a fan favorite, but that's okay.
You mean not always a show favorite?
Well, okay, that too.
What are you calling for?
Did you guys talk about the most important item on your agenda for today?
We already talked about it, and Mike said, and so did our little buddy from down under.
What did he say?
He doesn't know what they've done for us. He's upset that you're excited about the birth or about the new pregnancy.
Oh, whatever, Mikey. I'm just wondering, is it Puerto Rico and they don't have such a thing? That's why.
Is it too late
if
for
you had
Plan B?
The Queens of Puerto Rico, still, you would be happy.
We never had one, but is it too late for Plan B?
What?
Is it too late for Plan B?
Yeah, that's what it is.
The morning after pill. It doesn't work still. Did we miss that window?
Did you realize it's the Royals? They want nothing.
Yeah, another bloodsucker that's going to be supported by the taxpayers.
Okay, not us. No, taxpayers.
Over there.
The taxpayers agreed to it. They're okay with it.
They agreed to it, so the prince went to the taxpayers and said, "Look, I'm going to knock her up again."
Okay,
you guys down with that?
Hey, they vote every year every 10 years, or how often do they vote over there about that?
To give them money?
Yeah.
People yes, okay and they're okay with it. Hey, if it makes them happy, it makes me happy. And now there's going to be a little royal invasion.
Now,
in the
I do have a question for you, caller, because this is funny, because our little buddy from down under who's currently in China asked the same question. How is it that a Mexican in America is enamored with the royals over there?
It's funny that you asked that, because I was going to be like, if you like him so much, what the hell are you doing in this country?
Oh, trust me. I wish I lived in the UK, but I don't. You know what? I think it goes back to Princess Diana.
You realize that the women in the UK have hairy armpits and gaps between their teeth.
Who does?
Women in the UK.
They do? Have you been there? Have you seen them? I've seen them, and they don't.
Well, not the princess, but everybody else does.
Oh, Mr.
Well,
you
realize Princess Diana has been there for, what, like 15, 20 years now?
It's been 17 years.
It's okay. That was a real princess. She was classy. She was beautiful. That's it. That was the last good princess around.
Are you saying that this one's not?
How do you know that was
classy?
The last good one? I mean, the royals currently right now are good people.
Yeah. No.
Oh, that's
if you compare any of the royals today to Princess Di, they're all well below the standard.
Really?
Yes.
Did you know that Prince Harry and Prince William, they work for a living?
Yeah.
Prince William is going back to work, and he's donating his paycheck to charity.
Yes. Well, he doesn't need his paycheck. The government supports him.
When have you ever deposited your check to charity, Mikey?
Well, if the government was supporting me, I would, too.
I'm going to say, I don't think so.
All right, caller, you're getting hostile.
Either.
We're going to cut you off because the show's coming to an end.
The only thing I like about those two is that they do serve in the military. That's it.
Mikey,
there you go. See
Mikey,
what I mean?
I think
Princess Diana raised two well-educated men. That's
no, they have to, because otherwise they would be called wusses.
Mikey, you sound a little hostile. Do you and the caller want to
get
I
caller.
Know, he get, is a little hostile.
Are you trying to
oh,
get
and
the,
then the other thing, that football player whose girlfriend got beat up in the elevator and all that other stuff.
Yes.
She's such an idiot. Why would she stay with somebody who keeps her behind like that?
Because
And I don't even want to hear the comments between Arvin and Mike
because of the
I already know what your comments are going to be.
Because of the lifestyle.
He's just an idiot.
Excuse me, caller. Do you want to go on an elevator right about now?
Yeah, go ahead.
You know what?
See what happens.
I tell you what, if he was going to give me that lifestyle, I'd let him knock me out every once in a while.
Seriously?
Yeah.
And that's what you're
talking
email
about me
again, Mikey?
I'm
Mikey
talking about
at the
me.
Three Guys Rant?
Yes, it's Arvin at the Three Guys Rant.
I don't think so. Mikey, you're making me very upset. I say I'm going to hang up now.
All right, and this just thing, we have
okay,
a clip.
Thank you.
We have a clip of what the prince said to the queen when he got her knocked up.
Here we go.
No, don't even play that because it's
say my
rubbish.
Name.
One more time, please.
Now, say my name.
All right,
is that what you demand, Mr. Arvin? Anyways, that was my rant of the day.
Thank you, caller.
Thank you, caller.
All right, guys. Talk to you later.
See you later.
Now, you know, you guys know that I'm usually the first one to say that the women are the idiots. But this time, this week, I'm going to go with, and it's the end of the show. I was about to bash men. We'll have to save it for next week. But again, thank you for everybody for tuning in. Another rant episode of the Three Guys Rant here on NBC News Radio KCAA 1050 AM. Make sure to check us out at the3guysrant.com.